Okay, students, good morning to all of you. See, in previous class we are discussing about the vector laws of addition. In that first law we discussed, that is triangular law of vector addition. Students, triangular law of vector addition we will use to add any two vectors which are in different directions, and if two vectors p bar and q bar are making some angle between them, then resultant of the two vectors will be equal to square root of p square plus q square plus 2pq cos theta. Okay, so on that we are discussing some points. Yes, see, let us take resultant r is equal to under root of p square plus q square plus 2pq cos of angle theta between the two vectors. Okay, na? Yes, students, in last class only I explained you that if two vectors are equal, p is equal to q, magnitude wise if they are equal, magnitude of two vectors are equal to something p, let us call, and if angle between them is 0 degrees, then r will become p plus q. If angle between them is 180 degrees, then resultant will become p minus q. Means here p and q are equal, then you will get 0 here, you will get, sorry, here you will get 2 times of p, here you will get 0. Are you getting? P is equal to q, add to p, q is equal to p, add, subtract, you will get 0. Okay, na? And if the angle between the two vectors is 90 degrees, yes, this is very important, angle between the two vectors is 90 degrees, then r will become root 2 times of p. Do you remember this one? Substitute theta is equal to 90, this total will become 0. P square plus p square, root of 2p square, p square will come out as p. You should remember the fix them. And if angle between them is 60 degrees, then r will become root 3 times of p. Do you remember? Yes, you should remember these points. And if angle between them is 120 degrees, then r will become just p. These are the three main important points you must remember. Okay, students, you may get such easy questions sometimes in NEET examination, CET examination. Means this may be a part of your total question in physics. So these are very useful for you in competitive exams. Okay, so remember these points. Next, let us move on to second law of vector addition. Students, second law of vector addition, that is the parallelogram law. What is parallelogram law? See, parallelogram law also we will use to find resultant of any two vectors when they are added together. If you want to add two vectors, we can use triangular law or we can use parallelogram law. So for adding, why two vectors are, a small difference is there, I will explain. Students, in triangular law, let us suppose one vector is like this and another vector is like this. Then the resultant of these two is given like this, r is equal to p bar plus q bar. Triangular law states that if p bar and q bar represent two sides of a triangle, then their resultant vector is given by closing side of the triangle. Are you getting? But students, sometimes, see, here angle is zero, here angle is theta, but sometimes these two vectors may be co-initial vectors. Like this, let us suppose here one vector is there like this p bar, and here another vector is there like this q bar. These two are starting from same point. These are called as co-initial vectors. Now how to add these two? Let us suppose we cannot shift it and we cannot keep it here. Then what to do? How to add? if angle between them is theta, let us suppose, then we should use parallelogram law. Are you getting? So parallelogram law is useful to add two vectors which are coinitial, which are acting at same point. In physics, where we will get, sir? See, students, let us suppose this is one surface. On this surface, let us suppose there is one block of mass m. One mass m is there. Now we want to pull it. What we will do? We will tie with one rope and we will apply a force. Let us suppose this person who is applying the force is unable to pull this mass. Then what we will do? We will apply another rope and we will pull it with another force. Okay, na? Are you getting? And let us suppose the angle between them is theta. Then what is F1 plus F2 value? How much? See, force is a vector quantity, na? We should add them. How to add? According to vectors, we should add. For adding these type of vectors, which are starting from same point, which are acting on the same particular point, one particular point, we should use parallelogram law. Application understood, no? If the second vector is coinciding with the head of first vector, then triangular law we can use. Or if the second vector is coincident with the first vector, then we can't use a triangular law, because for a triangular law, two vectors which are adding, that should be in the same order. Here two vectors we have to add. They are not in a particular order. This vector is like this. This vector is like this. It is not in one particular order. Clockwise or anti-clockwise sense not there. We can use triangular. We can't use triangular law in this case. So we should go with parallelogram law. Yes. So how to use this parallelogram law, and what is the statement and what is the proof? Let us see. Students, let us suppose here there are two vectors are there. One is, let us call P bar. Another one is, let us call, yes, somewhat big I'll draw. Another one is, let us call it is Q bar. Like this. Two vectors are there. And these are starting from same point, making some angle theta between them. Now, students, let us give one name for this. OA is first vector P bar and OB is second vector Q bar. Length of Q bar is OB, length of P bar is OA. And OA is in the direction of O2A, is along X axis. Q bar is making some angle theta with X axis. Now we should add these two. We can't use triangular law. We can close this by one more. But for this P and Q should be in one particular clockwise or anti-clockwise sense. They are not like that. So we can't use. So for that, what we should do is, with the help of these two vectors, we should construct one parallelogram. Let us construct one parallelogram. Okay. Parallel to this OA, let us draw one more line like this. How much length is there? Same that much length line you draw. And parallel to OB, draw one more line like this. Okay. Now it is a parallelogram. Yes. Let us call this is C point. Here they are intersecting. Now it becomes a parallelogram because these two are parallel sides and these two are parallel sides. Because these two are parallel sides, this is P bar means this is also P bar, and this is Q bar means this is also Q bar. Got it? Students, understanding, no? Yes. Now you got again like triangle. This is P bar. This is Q bar means this is also Q bar. Now these two are in a particular order. P bar and Q bar are in particular order. Like this P bar is there. Like this Q bar is there. Now resultant of these two can be given by resultant vector r bar. Finished. Now between P and Q, how much angle is there? Yes, just extend this one. Because with this horizontal line, because these two are parallel lines, this angle is theta, means this is also definitely theta. Because for one particular horizontal line, two inclined lines are, two parallel lines are intersecting, then their angles also should be same. Now statement C, if P bar and Q bar represents two sides of a parallelogram, these are two sides of a parallelogram, then resultant of P bar and Q bar can be given by the diagonal of this parallelogram, which is equal in magnitude to opposite direction, like this. Resultant should be in this direction. If P bar and Q bar represent two sides of a parallelogram, then resultant of these two vectors is given by the diagonal of a parallelogram. Means this resultant we can write R bar is equal to P bar plus Q bar. That's it. So what we have done? First we are having these two. We are having these two. So these two parallel vectors we have drawn. Now it has formed one triangle. Now these two triangles, these two sides, we can close by one more line, R bar, OC. That R bar can be written as P bar plus Q bar according to triangular law, we can say. So if P and Q are two sides of a parallelogram which are making some angle theta with each other, then resultant of these two can be written as P bar plus Q bar. We should add according to vectors. Magnitude, how much we need to find now? Okay, yes, to find the magnitude, again students, from this C drop one perpendicular, let us call this is M. Okay, now let us suppose this AM is something X and CM is something Y. Now you are having one right angle triangle. AMC is a right angle triangle. Here 90 degrees angle. AMC is again right angle triangle. Now in this right angle triangle, what is cos theta, Nana? Cos theta is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse. So cos theta can be written as, what is theta? Adjacent side is x upon hypotenuse is q. So x can be written as Q cos theta. Yes, it is Q cos theta. Similarly, from this triangle AMC, what is sine theta? Sine theta is nothing but opposite side. Opposite side by hypotenuse. So sine theta can be written as opposite side for this theta is Y. Y by hypotenuse is Q. Now Y can be written as Q sine theta. So this is Q sine theta. Now again, if you observe, there is one more right angle triangle, OMC. OMC is one right angle triangle again. Now see this one. Now in this right angle triangle, OM is adjacent side, which is equal to P plus Q cos theta. CM is opposite side, which is equal to Q sin theta, and OC is the diagonal hypotenuse. Now applying Pythagoras theorem, apply Pythagoras theorem for OMC triangle, we can say OC square is equal to, O2C square is equal to OM square plus CM square. OM square plus CM square. Correct? Yes. OC is nothing but R. So R square is equal to OM. O to M is P up to O, up to AP plus A to M is Q sin Q cos theta whole square plus CM is Q sin theta. Q sin theta whole square. So you'll get R square is equal to A plus B whole square. A square plus B square plus 2AB. I have written A plus B whole square plus Q square sine square theta. Q square sine square theta. Then you will get R square is equal to P square as it is. Now Q square here is there, here is there. Take Q square common. You will get here sine square theta plus here cos square theta plus this term 2PQ cos theta. That implies R square can be written as P square plus Q square. This is 1. This total value is 1. Okay, plus 2PQ cos theta. Then R will become under root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Again, result is same. Whatever you do, triangular law, parallelogram law, resultant magnitude will get same. Only the difference is where to use triangular law, where to use parallelogram law. That you should understand. That's it. How many of you understood this one? Yes. Good. So parallelogram law we will use when two vectors are intersecting at one particular point. Resultant will be root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta only. Yes. Now one more polygon law. Yes, it is important. Now students, listen carefully. Polygon law of vector addition A, totally right. Polygon law of vector addition. Yes, what is this polygon law of vector addition? Poly in the sense more, many, more than 3, 2, 4. Okay.
Yes.
Students, let us suppose there are so many vectors are there, like this. One vector, let us call this is A bar vector. One more vector, let us call this is B bar vector. One more vector, let us call this is C bar vector. One more like this, let us suppose D bar vector. Like this, many vectors are there, let us suppose. Or you consider like this. Here A bar is there, B bar like this is there, C bar like this is there. Okay, na? And D bar like this is there. So many vectors are there, which are in different directions. Okay. Now we should add them. More than 3 vectors are there. More than 2 vectors are there. We should add them. How to add? Students, I told you one trick while adding the vectors. Which vector you are adding, that vector tail should come in contact with first vector. Okay. Let us do that. Students, let us suppose this is my first vector. Yes. First vector is here, A bar. Now to this, I have to add B bar, let us suppose. Now what to do? B bar inclination angle we should not change, but we can shift it up or down. Okay, up or down, forward or backward we can do, but we should not change its inclination. Now, without changing its direction, let us bring this vector and keep in contact with the head of first vector. Tail of this second vector should come in contact with the head of first vector. Yes, let us do. So without shifting, this is B bar. Done. Okay. Now for these two, I should add third vector. Let us suppose C bar I should add. What to do? Yes, students, third vector tail should come in contact with the head of second vector without shifting its direction. Keep it here. C bar. Now for these three together, I should add fourth vector. Let us suppose. Okay, fourth vector is like this. Keep it here. D bar. Okay, na? Now we are adding A bar, B bar, C bar, and D bar all. Now there is one more gap is there. If you fill that gap, it will become total one polygon. Correct. Now resultant of all these four vectors can be given by the closing side of this polygon, which is taken in opposite order. Got it, students? If some vectors represents different sides of a polygon which are taken in one particular order, then the resultant of all these three vectors, all these vectors can be given by the closing side of that polygon. That's it. I hope you understood what is the statement. If some vectors represents sides of a polygon taken in one particular order, then resultant of all that vectors can be given by closing side of that polygon. That's it. How, sir, how we will get this resultant? A simple technique, students. First we are to add A and B. A and B resultant, let us suppose something P. How much it is? You can write P is equal to A plus B. Correct? According to triangular law, A plus B is equal to something P. Now this A and B is not there with you. Only P is there. That P indicates A plus B, A bar plus B bar. Now let us suppose we have to add P and C. You will get, see, these two are in same order. Now closing side of this triangle will be given by like this. Let us suppose there is something Q bar. Then according to triangular law, Q bar can be written as P bar plus C bar. Now P bar and C bar are not there with you. Now you are having Q and D. Now Q bar in this direction, D bar is in this direction. These two are in one particular order. According to triangular law, resultant of these two sides of a triangle can be given by closing side. Means closing side, let us imagine it is R bar. This can be written as Q bar plus D bar. Yes. But what is Q bar? Q bar is nothing but P bar plus C bar, and D bar is there. But what is P bar? P bar is nothing but A bar plus D bar. Here plus C bar is there, plus D bar is there. Yes. This is the resultant. Finished. All vectors we have added. Means polygon law also based on triangular law only. Triangular law we will use if you want to add two vectors. Polygon law we will use to add more than two vectors. Any doubt in this polygon law factor addition? waiting for your response. Good. So if you want to add number of vectors, what you can use? You can use polygon law. Just arrange all that vectors in such a manner that all are in one particular order. Now resultant of all that vectors can be given by closing set of that polygon. Students, one student is asking me, sir, when to use parallelogram law? Students, parallelogram law we will use when two vectors are starting from one particular point. When two vectors are acting at one particular point, to add that two vectors which are making some angle theta between them, we have to use parallelogram law. Okay? Now let us see some properties of vector addition. Students, it is important, Anna. Properties of vector addition. Yes. First one, Anna. Commutative property. Property. What is commutative property? Students, let us suppose we are having A bar and B bar. We should add them. Then this addition, we can add like this also. Let us suppose we are having two vectors, A and B. We can add B to A or we can add A to B. That's it. But both we gives you same result. See, graphically let us see this. Students, let us suppose I am having two vectors A bar and one more B bar like this. I want A plus B. A bar plus B bar I want. Second vector I should add, no? Second vector tile should come in contact with first vector. A bar without shifting its direction. Keep it here. B bar gives you this resultant. R is equal to A plus B. If you want to add first vector to second vector, what you should do? First to draw first vector B bar. Now what to do, Nana? Second vector tail should come in contact with first vector without shifting its angle. Yes. Bring and keep it here. B bar plus A bar. See, resultant is coming like this. R is equal to A bar plus B bar. Students, you observe carefully resultant vector A bar plus B bar, A bar plus B bar. But you observe directions. Yes, see my hands, both are in same direction. If you do A plus B in this direction, if you do B plus A also in this direction. Means vector addition can be commutative. You can add A plus B or B plus A. Okay? Important. You can do anything. You can add first vector to second vector or second vector to first vector. This property is called as commutative property. Remember. Okay? Next. Associative property. Second one. Associative property. Associative property is nothing but, let us suppose we are having three vectors. A plus B plus C. This you can add in two different manners. First you can add B and C. For that you can add A. Or A plus B plus C. First you can add A and B. For this you can add C. Or you can add A to B and C. Anything you can do. Okay. Students, see. Let us suppose I am having vectors A bar here, B bar is here, and
C bar is here. Can you see clearly?
Yes. Now I want A plus B plus C. What you will get? See, A plus B, add these two. Something P you will get. Now this add to this. P plus C. You will get this resultant. R is equal to P plus C. That P is nothing but A plus B. Means here you are getting P plus C. P is nothing but A plus B together. And for this we are adding C. Same thing we can get, same resultant we can get by doing different manner. See, first add these two, B and C add. B and C add. Let us suppose this is something Q. Now, this Q and this A we should add. Again, resultant is the same again. Now, in that case, R can be written as A plus Q. That is, A plus Q is nothing but B plus C. Both are same. In both the cases, we got same resultant. This property is called as associative property. Whenever you are having three vectors and we have to add them, you can add first two vectors and then add third vector. Or you can add second two vectors and add first vector to that. Associative property. Next, one more. Distributive property. Students, let us suppose we are having something constant and we should add we should multiply that constant with A plus B. Then you can do that like K into A bar plus K into B bar. This is called as distributive. A plus B is one vector is there with us. For that we have to multiply K. You can multiply this K with A bar and multiply K with B bar and add together. This is called as distributive property. Vector addition follows commutative property, associative property and distributive property. Nana. Important. You must remember this. Okay?
Yes.
Friends, in next class, we will discuss about multiplication of vectors, product of two vectors. Addition is over, subtraction is, however, it is easy. Let us discuss about multiplication of vectors. Okay? Yeah, I hope you understand it very clearly. Any doubts in it? Any doubts? No, sir. Good. Okay. So in next class we'll continue now. Okay, bye.